Hello, welcome to European Open Briefing for Thursday, February 28th. I'm Rafa Boyajian, currency analyst at XM.com, and we're going to be taking a look at what's happening in the currency markets today. So we've got quite a bit of risk-off sentiment this morning. We can see most equity indices are in the red. The US dollar is slightly weaker this morning, although it is off the lows it touched yesterday. So yesterday, the dollar did get a bit of a lift from comments by the US trade representative cautioning about a quick trade deal with China. So we saw the dollar benefiting from some safe haven demand. The yen is also firmer, so we've got those tensions between India and Pakistan. We also just heard that the summit between US President Donald Trump and the North Korean leader ended without any deal. Plus, we've got renewed concerns about China's economy following some disappointing PMI numbers out of China earlier today. So dollar-yen is slightly lower at 110.80. Euro, though, is up at the moment at 1.1381. Sterling surged above the 1.33 level yesterday, so it has since paired some of those gains. But the Australian dollar, which despite the fact that we saw some strong data out of Australia earlier, is being weighed by the risk-off sentiment. It's doing a little bit better now. It was down earlier today. The Kiwi is also down. We had some disappointing business confidence numbers out of New Zealand. Oil prices are down mainly on the back of worries about China's economy. Yesterday, though, it did recover its losses from earlier in the week on a surprise drop in US inventories. Gold is up, though overall the gold has been trading very much sideways in recent days. So having a look now at the major pairs, we can see the dollar index steadily declining during February, but it did manage to recover from those three-week lows touched yesterday. So the US Trade Representative Robert Lighthizer has basically downplayed the chances of a quick deal between the US and China on trade, saying it's too early to predict the outcome of the talks. But on the positive side, he did say that the those planned tariffs increases from 10 to 25% on $200 billion worth of Chinese imports would be suspended until further notice. So that suggests that talks will continue at least for the time being. The immediate focus for the dollar will be the fourth quarter GDP numbers out of the US. So these were delayed due to the government shutdown during January. So they will, these are the initial estimates, they will finally be released at 13:30 GMT. Talking about the factors generating some risk off this morning, so we've got those tensions between India and Pakistan, which then now appear to be subsiding at least for the time being. We had the announcement that the summit between Trump and Kim didn't end without any deal, so no deal will be signed as North Korea is demanding that all sanctions be lifted before taking any steps in denuclearization. We also had some disappointing economic numbers. Chinese manufacturing PMI fell unexpectedly and Japanese industrial output slumped in January, so all of that weighing on market sentiment. But despite all that, gold is only up marginally at the moment at around $1,320 an ounce. Looking at sterling, it has fallen back to around the 1.33 level yesterday. Yesterday it did touch a 7.5 months high, 1.3349. So Theresa May's plan to hold the next vote by March the 12th, and then if this gets voted down, to allow MPs to vote whether or not they want a no-deal Brexit, and then if they choose to rule out a no-deal Brexit, then they would get to vote on extending Article 50. So this particular plan has been approved by MPs, and so that has significantly reduced the chances of a no-deal Brexit. So there's a chance that the this vote could arrive as early as next week if May gets her assurances from the EU on the Irish backstop issue, and then is able to put that revised plan, a revised deal, to MPs. Looking at the Australian dollar, earlier we did see very quick spike due to stronger than expected capital expenditure numbers out of Australia for the fourth quarter, pointing to strong GDP growth. But then we had the Chinese manufacturing PMIs, which disappointed. So those were for February. So we saw the Aussie falling back a little bit. And of course, the overall risk off also weighing on the Aussie, as well as the New Zealand dollar. The New Zealand dollar also down on the back of a sharp drop in business confidence in New Zealand in February. To watch for the Kiwi later today will be the terms of trade numbers for the fourth quarter. So that's it for me. Thank you much for watching and have a great day.